स्वाति माता जी, कैन यू सी माई स्क्रीन? माता जी
या सॉरी, आई वाज ऑन म्यूट. या आई कैन सी योर स्क्रीन.
गो
कैन
अहेड
आई
माता जी.
स्टार्ट रीडिंग? ओके.
यस माता जी, गो अहेड.
श्री श्री राला प्रभुपदा, दिस मूवमेंट इज एस्पेशली मेंट टू एनेबल अ ह्यूमन बीइंग टू रीच द रियल गोल ऑफ लाइफ. बॉब, द रियल गोल, श्री राला, द रियल गोल ऑफ लाइफ. बॉब, इज द रियल गोल ऑफ लाइफ टू नो गॉड? बॉब, ओके. श्री राला, यस, टू गो बैक होम. Sri Rala Prabhupada, yes, to go back home, back to Godhead, this is real goal of life. The water that comes from the sea forms clouds. The clouds fall down as rain, and the actual goal is to flow down the river and again enter the sea. So we have come from God, and now we are embarrassed by material life. Therefore, we aim, our aim should be to get out of this embarrassing situation and go back home, back to Godhead. This is real goal of life. Mam upatyaya punar janma dukhalayam
ashashvatam
asasvatam napunvanti mahatna sami siddhin pramam gatha. I'm sorry for misspelling those words. After attaining me, the great souls who are yogis in devotion never return to this temporary world, which is full of miseries, because they have attained the highest perfection. This is version of Bhagavad Gita. If anyone comes to me, Mam Upatyaya, he does not come back again. Where? To this place. Dukhalayam Asaswatam. This place is the abode of mysteries. Everyone knows, but they have been befooled by so-called leaders. Material life is miserable life. Krishna says, God says that this is the place, this place is Dukhalayam. This is place of miseries. And this is also asasvatam, temporary. You cannot make a compromise. All right, let it be miserable. I shall remain here as an American or Indian. No, that also you cannot do. You cannot remain an American. You may think that having been born in America, you are very happy, but you cannot remain an American for long. You will have to be kicked out of the place, and your next life you do not know. Therefore, this is Dukhalayam Asaswatam, miserable and temporary. That is a philosophy. That is our philosophy, Bob. But when you have some knowledge of God, then life is not so miserable. Sri Rala Prabhupada. No, some knowledge will not do. You must have perfect knowledge. Jarma karma cha me divyam.
Karma cha me divyam.
Tatvaha means perfectly. Perfect knowledge is being taught in Bhagavad Gita. So we are giving everyone in human society a chance to learn Bhagavad Gita as it is and make his life perfect. That is Krishna consciousness movement. Why does your science say about transmigration of soul? Bob, I think that science cannot deny or affirm it. Science does not know it. Sri Rala Prabhupada. Therefore, I say that science is imperfect. Bob, science may though say something, it is said in the science that energy is never destroyed, it is changed. Srila Prabhupada, that's all right, but how the energy is working in the future, that science does not know. How is energy diverted? How? By different manipulations. Is the energy working differently? For instance, electrical energy. By different handling, it is operating the heater and it is operating the refrigerator. They are just the opposite, but the electrical energy is the same. Similarly, this energy, living energy, how is it being directed? Which way it is going? How it is fructifying in the next life? They do not know, but in Bhagavad Gita, it is very simply stated, Vasami jirnani yata vidaha. You're covered by dress, by a shirt. When the shirt is unusable, you change it. Similarly, this body is just like shirt and coat. When it is no longer workable, we have to change it. Bob, what is we that has to change? What is constant? Srila Prabhupada, that is the soul. Bob, from one life to the next, Srila Prabhupada, that is soul, I. What you is speaking, you. What I is speaking, identity, Atma or soul. Bob, my soul is different from your soul. Srila Prabhupada, yes, you are an individual soul, I am an individual soul. Bob, you have removed yourself from karmic influences. If I was to remove myself from karmic influences, would our souls be the same or different? Srila Prabhupada, the soul is of same quality in all. You are under certain conception of life at present moment, and these countrymen of yours, the Krishna consciousness, were under a certain conception of life, but by training they have taken to another conception of life. So the ultimate training is how to become Krishna consciousness. That is perfection. Bob, if two people are Krishna conscious, is their soul the same? Srila Prabhupada, the soul is always the same. Bob, in each person it is the same. Srila Prabhupada, yes. Bob, pointing to two devotees, if these two are Krishna consciousness, are their souls the same? Srila Prabhupada, the soul is the same, but always in individual. Even if one is not Krishna consciousness, for instance, you are human being and I am a human being. If I am not Christian, even if you are not a Hindu, still we are human beings. Similarly, the soul may not be Krishna conscious, but he may be Krishna conscious. It doesn't matter, but the soul is soul. Bob, can you tell me more about this? Srila Prabhupada, soul are pure spirit and all souls are equal, even in an animal. Therefore, it is said, Pandita those who are actually learned to see the outward covering, either in a human being or an animal. Bob, if I may ask another question on this, Srila Prabhupada, yes, Bob. I have considered the soul somewhat as a part of God. At times, I think I feel God. I'm here and you may say God is here. So if the soul is inside me, then should I be able to feel God inside me? Not all of God, I mean, but Srila Prabhupada, part of God. Bob, but I don't feel God in me, but God may be here separate from me. But should I be able to feel God inside me since my soul is pure of God, part of God? Srila Prabhupada, yes, God is inside also. God is everywhere. God is inside and outside also. This is to be known. Bob, how do you feel God inside you? Srila Prabhupada, not in the beginning, but you have to know from Shastras, scriptures, by Vedic information. For example, in Bhagavad Gita, it is said, Ishvara Sarva Bhutam Hartesi Arjuna Trisasti. God is there in everyone's heart. Parmanu Sayantara Stam. God is also within every atom. So that is the first information. And then by yogic process, you have to realize it. Bob, yogic process, Srila Prabhupada, yes. Bob, is chanting Hare Krishna such a yogic process? Srila Prabhupada, yes, it is also a yogic process. Bob, what kind of yogic process must I do to find out, to feel this information, to feel the soul inside? Srila Prabhupada, yes, there are so many different yogic processes, but for this age, this process is very nice. Bob, chanting. Srila Prabhupada, yes. Bob, through this, I can feel not only God outside, but God inside. Srila Prabhupada, you'll understand everything of God, how God is inside, how God is outside, how God is working. Everything will be revealed. By this attitude of service, God will reveal himself. You cannot understand God by endeavor. Only if God reveals himself, for instance, when the sun is out of your sight at night, you cannot see it by your torchlight or by any light. But in the morning, you can see the sun automatically without any torchlight. Similarly, you have to create a situation. You have to put yourself in a situation in which God will be revealed. It is not that by some method you can ask God, please come, I will see you. No, God is not your order carrier, Bob. You must please God for him to reveal himself. Is that correct, Srila Prabhupada? Yes. Shama Sundara, how do we know when we are pleasing God? Srila Prabhupada, when we see him, then you ask, then you will understand. Just as when you eat, you do not require to ask anyone whether you are feeling strength or hunger, or your hunger is satisfied. If you eat, you understand that you are feeling hungry. If you don't need to inquire about from anyone. Similarly, if you actually serve God, then you will understand God is dictating to me. God is there. I am seeing God, a devotee or God's representative. Srila Prabhupada. Yes, devotee. It comes easiest. Srila Prabhupada. You have to go through God's representative. Yasya Prasadat Bhagavat Prasadaha. By the mercy of spiritual master, one is benedicted by the mercy of Krishna. If you please God's representative, then automatically God becomes pleased, and thus you can directly see him. An Indian gentleman, how to please God's representative? Srila Prabhupada. You have to carry out.
This is one of the important questions. Please listen carefully and attentively. Yes, Mataj, go ahead.
Srila Prabhupada, you have to carry out his orders, that's all. God's representative is Guru. He asks you to do this, to do that. If you do that, that is pleasing. Without the grace of spiritual master, one cannot make any advancement. If you displease him, then you are nowhere. Therefore, we worship the Guru. Saksat Daritvena Samasta Sastriyar Uktas Tatha Bhavyatha Iva Sadvi Kintu Prabhurya Priya Iva Tasya Vande Guru Shri
Charanavinda.
The spiritual master is to be honored as much as the Supreme Lord because of his being the most confidential servitor of the Lord. This is acknowledged by all revealed scriptures and is followed by all authorities. Therefore, I offer my respectful obeisances unto the lotus feet of such spiritual master who is bona fide representative of Lord Krishna. The Guru should be accepted as God. That is injunction of all the Shastra.
Bob, I want to say this highlighted point. The Guru should be accepted as God. This is the injunction of all the Shastras. Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Guru. The Guru should be accepted as a representative of God. Srila Prabhupada. Yes, the Guru is God's representative. The Guru is external manifestation of Krishna. Bob, but different from the incarnation of Krishna that come. Srila Prabhupada. Yes, Bob. In that way, is the external manifestation of the Guru different from external manifestation of, let us say, Krishna or Chaitanya when they come to earth? Srila Prabhupada. The Guru is representative of Krishna. So, there are symptoms of who is a guru. The general symptoms are described in Vedas. Tad vijnanardham saguru eva bigachat samitpana stotram brahman nistam. A guru must come in disciple in disciplic succession, and he must have heard thoroughly about the Vedas from his spiritual master. Generally, a guru's symptom is that he's perfect devotee, that's all. He serves Krishna by preaching his message. Bob, Lord Chaitanya, he was different type of guru than you are. Srila Prabhupada, no. Gurus cannot be of different types, but all gurus are of one type. Bob, but he was. Was he also an incarnation at the same time? Srila Prabhupada. Yes, he is Krishna himself, but he is representing the Guru. Bob, I see. Srila Prabhupada. Yes, Bob. And then Srila Prabhupada. Because Krishna was God, he was demanded. Sarva dharman parityajna mam ekam saranam vraja. Abandon all varieties of religion and just surrender unto me. But people misunderstood him. Therefore, Krishna again became a guru and taught people how to surrender to Krishna. Shyama Sundara. Doesn't he say in Bhagavad Gita, I am the spiritual master? Srila Prabhupada.
Yes, we get so many questions here. Please attentively listen this part also. Does he say in Bhagavad Gita, I am the spiritual master? Many people have confusion at here. It will be revealed at this. Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Srila Prabhupada. Yes, he is the original master because he was accepted as spiritual master by Arjuna. So what is a difficulty? Sisyas teham sadhimam tvam prapanam. Arjuna told the Lord, I am your disciple and your soul surrendered unto me. Please instruct me. So unless he's a spiritual master, how does Arjuna become his disciple? He's original guru. Tene brahma harta ya adi kavaye. He is only... he is only who first imparted Vedic knowledge unto the heart of Brahma, the Brahma, the first created being. Therefore, he is original Guru. Bob, Krishna. Srila Prabhupada. Yes, he is original Guru. Then his disciple Brahma is a Guru. Then his disciple Narada is a Guru. Then his disciple Vyasa is a Guru. In this way, there is a Guru Parampara. Disciplic success of gurus. Evam parampara praptam. The transcendental knowledge is received through the disciplic succession. Bob. So a guru receives his knowledge through the disciplic succession, not directly from Krishna. Do you receive some knowledge directly from Krishna? Srila Prabhupada.
Here also we'll get the important... sorry to interrupt you, Mataji. Here also we'll get one of the important question. Please attentively listen this part also. Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Yes, Krishna's direct... Bob. So, a guru receives his knowledge to disciplic succession, not directly from Krishna. Do you receive some direct knowledge directly from Krishna? Srila Prabhupada. Yes, Krishna's direct instruction is there. Bhagavad Gita. Bob, I see. But Srila Prabhupada. But you have to learn it through the disciplic succession. Otherwise, you will misunderstand it. Bob. But presently, you do not receive information directly from Krishna. It comes to disciplic succession from the books. Srila Prabhupada, there is no difference. Suppose I say that is a pencil. If you have to say to him, there is a pencil, and if he says to another man, this is a pencil, then what is the difference between his instruction and my instruction? Bob, Krishna's mercy allows you to know this now. Srila Prabhupada, you can take Krishna's mercy also, provided it is delivered as it is. Just as we are teaching Bhagavad Gita, the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Sarva Dharman Pratityajya Mam Ekam Saranam Vraja. Just give up all other forms of religion and simply surrender unto me. Now we are saying that you should give up everything and surrender to Krishna. Therefore, there is no difference between Krishna's instruction. Therefore, there is no difference between Krishna's instruction and our instruction. There is no deviation. So if you receive knowledge in the perfect way, that is as good as receiving instruction directly from Krishna. But we don't change anything. Bob, when I pray reverently, faithfully, does Krishna hear me? Srila Prabhupada, yes. Bob, from me to him, Srila Prabhupada. Yes, because he is within your heart. He is always hearing you, whether you are praying or not praying. When you are doing some nonsense, he is also good hearing you. But when you pray, that is very good. Welcome. Bob, to Krishna's ear, is praying louder than nonsense? Srila Prabhupada, no. He is all perfect. He can hear everything. Even if you don't speak, even if you simply think I shall do it, then he hears you. Sarvasya Chaham Hati. Okay. Krishna is seated in everyone's heart, but one should pray. Is that so? That is his business, praying. Whose business? Everyone's living entity. That is only business. Eko Bahunam Yo Vidati Kamam. This is a statement of the Vedas. What does that mean? He supplies everything to everyone, he supplies food to everyone, so he's a father. So why should you not pray, Father, give me this? Just as in the Christian Bible, there is Father, give us our daily bread. That is good. They are accepting the Supreme Father. But grown-up children should not ask from Father. Rather, they should be prepared to serve the Father. That is bhakti, devotion. Bob, my questions you resolve so nicely. Everyone laughs with affection. Srila Prabhupada, thank you very much, Bob. Should I ask you another question now, Srila Prabhupada? Oh, yes, yes.
Thank you, Mataji. There is no other questions. We are not continuing further. That continuation is there in the next chapter. And I thank everyone for your patience listening. And within a short time, within 5 minutes, I'll summarize this entire chapter. And I'll ask you for few questions. If you have further doubts, you can ask me that also. Once again, thanks for your patience listening. It's a little bit lengthy chapter. Let me summarize it. Hope everyone can see my screen.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Yes, thank you, Mataji and Prabhuji. This summary of this chart chapter, the real goal of life. My first question is, what is the real goal of life? It's very simple. In this module only, we come to know that to go back home, back to Godhead. This is the real goal of life. This is also stated in Bhagavad Gita. And second point is, to this place is called Dukkalayam Ashashvatam. We learned about this place is Dukkalayam and it is also Ashashvatam. This is temporary. But some people say that I want to remain in this world, but you will be kicked out of this place. I want to quote an example right here. When you take a train and if you reach your destination, you should get down. And you cannot say that, I have booked this ticket. This is not a permanent ticket in train also. But how can you say that you can stay here permanently? We cannot stay here. And we learned about this is the perfect knowledge. If you know about this perfect knowledge, you will be happy in this world and in Goloka Vrindavan also. If you go to spiritual world, there also you'll be happy. And fourth point is soul transmigrate from one body to another body. Excellent example is given by Srila Prabhupada. Some people ask how soul transmigrate from one body to another body. If soul is same, it should be remain in same body. Srila Prabhupada given example at here as electricity. Electricity is same for heater as well as refrigerator. Both are different things, but like same electricity used for heating as well as refrigeration. And we discussed about all souls are equal in all, even in animals. Like soul, there, we should not differentiate it. That whereas there is like no soul in another animals. We learned in previous chapters also that soul is there in even in animal. We learned about Pandita, like Pandita who sees everyone with equal vision. And soul is a pure spirit and all souls are equal even in animals. God is inside and God is everywhere. And my question, first question at here is, how can you feel God inside you? If anyone wants to answer, please answer to this question. From this module or with your own experience, please try to answer this question.
Prabhuji, God remains in our heart as a super soul, right? Paramatma.
Yes, Prabhu. How to realize it? My question is how to realize.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji.
By chanting, Prabhuji.
Yes, Malati Mataji, go ahead, Mataji.
Prabhuji, we can feel the presence of the God when only we have started the connection between Him. We have some consciousness about the presence of God and about the knowledge about Him by the scriptures or by listening classes. So, and by purificatory process, that is chanting, we can feel the presence of God and sometimes He'll guide us. So in that way, we can feel that He is present.
Okay. Anyone wants to add to this point? Snehal Mataji. Preeti Mataji, go ahead, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Prabhuji gave an example of that electricity, which is the same for heater and refrigerator. But unless we switch on the power, the electricity is not going to pass. So like that, unless we connect to the Lord through our scriptures, through seva service and the thought about God, then only that electricity is going to flow and it is causing cooling or heating.
No, Mataji. Actually, you said right, but you're not answered to my question. My question is, if God inside you, how to realize?
Realize. Sir, that is what Prabhuji, I want to say that the current, how it has to fire, the wire might be an empty cold wire unless the electricity is passed through the fire. The ignition should be there in our heart to realize that the God is there inside our heart only.
Okay. I'm expecting a complete answer. Please everyone participate it so that we'll have a nice discussion. Yes, Behra Prabhu, you can go ahead.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. Just I will take one example. Sometimes we keep some very valuable things like diamond or gold in our house. But if house is dark, even though gold is there inside house, we cannot search and find it. So for that, we need to light our house so that you can search it. Similarly, though God is present in our heart, we need to awaken our, means we should come out of our ignorance to the mode of goodness or through association of devotees and studying scriptures. And through following the instructions of Guru, then only we can see that soul, that God inside.
Yes, very good example, Prabhu. Very nice example. Like sometimes we not about darkness. Sometimes we keep the things which are very near to us. We can see it even though we'll search for it. Sometimes phone in your hand also, you'll search here and there. Where is my phone? Someone will say, "Son, your phone is in your hand. You are not aware of it. If you are aware of it, then you will be happy." In the similar way, God is there inside everyone's heart. Only thing is, we have to see it. And in coming questions, we will learn more about it. If you have any further queries or questions at here, you can ask me, or else we go further.
Prabhu, just to add on what Behra Prabhu has just said, consciousness level when we increase with association, and also when we are under direct disciplic guru who makes us to realize that God is inside us. So our guru helps us to know about God.
Yes, very good answer, Prabhu. And I'll reveal the answer which is there in the book. This seventh question, you have to know it from Shastras. As Malati Machit right said, by the Vedic information, by the attitude of service and by pleasing God, God reveal himself. Example at here is given by sun. If you want to see the sun, you have to wait for sun to rise. In the darkness, we cannot take torchlight and we cannot search for God. This example is given. And next question is, how do we know when we are pleasing God? I did a typographical error right here. Question is, how do we know and when we will come to know we are pleasing God?
Yes. Pleasing God in the sense, Prabhu, can you elaborate the question?
Probably the question is, how can you please the Lord? Is that what it is, Prabhu?
Yes. No, Prabhu. Yes, Prabhu. Or to submission. Actually, how do we know that we are pleasing Supreme Personality of God? How we will come to know it?
Okay, your personal experience.
Yes, your personal experience.
Okay, got it.
Anyone?
Puja Mataji has raised her hand.
Yes, Mataji, go ahead.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji. So I think when we are at peace, then I think we are able to please God.
Okay. Any other answer?
Yeah, Prabhu, when we serve God, basically with intention of serving, with a pure heart, that is where we will basically please God. He gets happy with our seva, pure seva.
Yes, Prabhu. Very right answer. Malati Mataji,
God had books. And as we are doing now this Vita Subodhi, connected to the devotees, we will be pleasing. That is my answer.
Mataji's, Prabhuji's, I have one little suggestion. So whenever we are answering, think in these ways. The way you can think is that Guru, Sadhu and Shastra. So when you are able to relate to all these, or at least one of them, you will be able to get the answer. So just think in these lines whenever you are trying to answer, that will become a right process also. So Guru, Sadhu and Shastra. What is Shastra saying about this question? So that also will really help us. What was the previous Guru Acharya was saying? What is our Srila Prabhupada saying? So that way also you can able to easily able to answer this kind of questions. Okay.
Shall I check, Prabhuji?
Thank you for your inputs. Yes, Mataji. Shall I?
By following the instructions of Guru.
Yes, Mataji. Marathi Mataji, you want to add any point at here?
Yes, Prabhuji, the same. We can understand God through Guru only. We cannot, with our own endeavor, we cannot understand Him. So with the help of the Guru or Devotee Association, we understand Him. Again, Krishna will get pleased by our devotion through following the spiritual master's instructions, and also doing the service to the servant of the God, Prabhuji. So in that way, we can please Krishna. By serving the devotees or other Vaishnavas, we can please Him.
Yes, Mataji. Bera Prabhu, you want to add anything, Prabhu?
So, Prabhuji, same thing only, because in this module, you come to know that Guru is a representative of God. So if you're able to satisfy Guru, then you will understand that we're satisfying the God.
Yes, Prabhu, very rightly said. And we got some answers in chat box also. This answer is from Sarala Mataji. Very accurate answer. When we are happy and peaceful. And Preeti Mataji said, yes, Mataji?
By offering ourselves to the Guru and following the instructions of the Guru.
Yes, Mataji. Very accurate answer is given by Sarala Mataji. Like when we are happy and peaceful, like we should be, like we saw many people, even though if they are having everything, they will not be peaceful and happy. We are thinking that people are running after money. And like yesterday we discussed about women, everything, but they are not happy. When we are dovetailing our every activity with Krishna, then we will be happy and we will be peaceful. And we learned about peace formula also in 5th chapter 5.29. In that way, we will be happy and we will be peaceful, and slowly we will realize about God. And in this module, Prabhupada has given an example, like how do we know that when we realize the God? Prabhupada given simple example. When you feel hungry, when you eat it, you will be satisfied. There is no need to come and says that you have eaten, then your hunger is satisfied. There is another certification is not required. It's yourself that you should be satisfied that I have realized the God. You yourself can say that I have seen, like I have realized the God. This is the answer given in this module. Vani Mataji, you want to say something, Mataji?
Actually, by reading the book, we'll get inspired. After getting the inspiration from the book, we'll think about the Guru, will teach us what is the book about. So I got the feeling and the experience about this. So I thought it is a good example, Prabhuji.
Okay, Mataji. Thank you, Mataji. Prabhu, you want to say something, Prabhu?
Prabhuji, I just wanted to ask you. Now, when you say that when I am peaceful and I am happy, that is the way that I can know that Supreme Lord is satisfied. If that is what it is, how do I know that I am not deceived by that? That means I might be happy for many other reasons. I might be peaceful for some other reason also. How do I dovetail that this is what is making the Supreme Lord happy? And you get my point, Prabhu, or should I
try to... Yes, Prabhu, I got your point, Prabhu. As far as my knowledge is concerned, I'll try to answer you, Prabhu. Radhisham Prabhu gives this example. One drunkard, he drunk fully and he fall near pit area, like muddy area. and everyone is showing pity. Aray, this fellow has drunken very much and he fell down. If I'm not wrong, Radhesham Prabhu himself went and he like lifted him and he helped him and he said, Aray, why you are suffering like this? He's saying, no, who told I'm suffering? I'm very happy and I'm very peaceful. People say like this, like if you ask the person who is running after money, if you ask him, Aray, why you are running after money? Why you are like not be happy and peaceful with whatever you have? People say, definitely they will say that whatever the route they are following, they says that my route is correct, my path is correct, my following is correct. But we learned that this Bhagavad Gita is a manual given by God. If you don't follow the instructions of Bhagavad Gita, you will not be happy. This is a manual given by God for human beings. For example, if you get a washing machine, Prabhu, and people will say that I will operate according to my wish, and this is the way you have to operate it. And if you operate it in that way, it will not give you a good service, as the service person has said to you. If you follow the instructions of the manual, then it will give you a good service. At the same time, life duration will be more. This, like, not, I'm not saying with these examples only, Prabhu. This, our seniors, acharyas, and everyone followed it. If you take an example of Ford company owner Amarendra, if I'm not wrong, Amarendra Prabhu is having crores of money, but even though he was not happy, when he come to the Krishna consciousness, he felt happy and he is leading a peaceful life. This live examples, when we see, then we can realize it, Prabhu. I think I answer to your questions, Prabhu, if I'm not wrong.
Yes, Prabhuji, go ahead.
Thank you, Prabhu. Vani Ram Mataji, you want to say something or by mistake you raised your hand? If no other follow-up question is there, I'll go further.
Prabhuji has said that by peace and by pleasing, you are saying, Prabhuji, what Krishna Swami has said. Prabhuji has said, by peace only we will be pleasing. One Mataji, someone has been told, and Krishna Swami also has been telling about, and I didn't get the connection of your saying with Krishna Swami. So I just wanted to simply you explain about.
I didn't get you, Mataji.
If a person is peace, he is happy.
Okay.
Always all people will be happy. They will be having problems. And whatever they have, they will be satisfying with that only, to some extent. But when a person who is very worried and has problems, so when that person is not pleasing with the life, so how he is connected to the God?
I am not getting your question, Mataji. Can anyone please help me to understand Mataji's question?
Yes, Prabhuji, shall I try?
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, so I guess what Mataji is trying to ask is, if a person is not having any problems, so how we can say that he will be in peace already, right? Because he don't have any problem. Anyhow, there is nobody who don't have problem, but still. So how we can say that person is connected to God? Like we see Mayavadis and all, they're happy with money. They are at peace if they have a lot of money. But they're not at all bothered about who God is and all. So he's at peace. How we can say that he's connected to God and he's pleasing the God?
Yes. Is it your question, Mataji?
Yes, Prabhuji.
Very, very good question, Mataji. Actually, frankly speaking, very good question. I'll try to answer it. Many people think that I don't have any problems. I'm leading my life comfortably. I met many people in my office itself. They're suffering. Like while getting up from the chair also, they're suffering. And they're saying, I don't have any problem. See, artificially, you can tell that I don't have any problems. Like if someone asks, like, Dhiruva Ambani, you don't have any problem. You cannot say that they don't have any problems. This lockdown, given us very good examples, like people have to face three types of problems. I hope everyone remember it, Adhyatmik, Adhibhautik, Adhidaivik. You cannot say that people don't have any problem. People have so many problems, Mataji. Once they connect to like God consciousness or Krishna consciousness, then they will become happy in this world, whereas if they go to spiritual also, they will be happy. I hope address your question, Mataji.
Yes, Prabhuji,
I wanted to add few things here. I know this is not an easy question to answer, and there is a little bit of confusion for sure. So let me see if I can bring in my little bit of inputs here to clarify. If you remember, in the second chapter, Krishna summarizes the entire Gita, and he gives the acronym for the second chapter as Gita. In that, yes, just okay, if you remember, A stands for what in Gita? A stands for Gita, G-I-T-A. A stands for what?
Atmaram.
Atmarama. So when you are following the instructions of the Supreme Lord, as given in Bhagavad Gita, as Govardhan Prabhu rightly mentioned, what you will finally achieve is what is your final state. That state is what is Atmarama state. And if you see how Krishna explains what is Atmarama is, Krishna explains an Atmarama is a person, he is unaffected. Please mark my words here, as Krishna is re-emphasizing, he is unaffected by happiness or distress, gain or loss, honor or dishonor. So if you are saying that when I am peaceful, I am happy, then only I am able to connect and if Krishna is happy. So that kind of explanation, I'm not sure in the module it has come out that way. But point to understand is that this is a material universe, like Dukkhalayam is saying. So here you are bound to get unhappiness. You are bound to get distressed. But in whatever kind of situation is there, if you are not affected, that is called Stitha Prajna state, or it is also called as Atmarama state. So eventually you will experience that. If you are able to experience that, that means you have come to a state where you are following the instructions of Bhagavad Gita, and Krishna is also going to reciprocate to you to give you that kind of a knowledge and to come to that state, which is called Atmarama state. Is that making sense, Prabhuji's, Mataji's?
Yes, Prabhuji.
So don't hanker for happiness. If you see, we have seen it in the past, the purest the devotees are gopis, and they don't hanker for happiness. They don't hanker for peace. It will automatically come, because why it will automatically come?
Because they are preaching Krishna.
Eventually you will attain that. How? Why?
Obviously we are connecting with Krishna.
Yeah, one last try.
We will be purified.
Yes, very close. But still one last try.
Surrendering to Krishna.
Bhaira Prabhu.
Because Krishna is there with us, so automatically we will be happy.
Okay, that is true. In one way, when you follow the instructions of Krishna, we'll come to a platform, we will no more be identifying ourselves with this material body. We will be more or less identifying ourselves as the spirit soul. Spirit soul natural constitutional position is to be happy, is to be peaceful. So that is the characteristic. And that characteristic, you will find it in Krishna too. And when you connect to Krishna, it is like we are, Srila Prabhupada gives a very beautiful example. He says that we are like Jada Pradarth. Jada Pradarth, he is talking about giving an example called iron rod. And we are iron rod, but once this iron rod comes in contact with fire, all the characteristics of the fire will come to the iron rod. But initially, you cannot say that. It is giving this iron rod, when it is connecting with the fire, it gets all the characteristics, including it is able to, when you touch it, it will burn you, it is going to give you light, everything. Tungsten filament, which is there, the bulb, what is it? So I'm sorry, Prabhuji, Govardhan Prabhuji, I'm taking a little more time. But the point what we need to understand here is that you don't have to hanker for this. If you are peaceful, you are not peaceful, doesn't matter for you. The point is that, are we able to connect to Krishna? And how do we connect to Krishna? Through devotees, through Guru. So that is how, when you connect, automatically things will fall in place and we will be able to realize your true identity, which is the Atmarama, which is the Sthita Prajna state also, you will come. Okay? So Prabhuji, I think I made my point. Please go ahead.
Pooja Mataji, you have any doubt? Mataji, you raised your hand.
I had one question, but I'll ask later. It's not related to this content. So.
Okay, Mataji. Let us finish this topic. If time permits,
we'll continue
with your question, Mataji.
Yeah, Hare Krishna.
Yeah, I hope everyone can see my screen. In this eighth point of the summary of this chapter is, by the mercy of spiritual master, one is benedicted by the mercy of Krishna. Like, if you please God representative, then automatically God becomes pleased and thus you can directly see him. And Atir, I have a question. How to please God representative? From this module, how do you come to know about, like, how can we please spiritual master?
Following his instructions.
Prabhu,
I was saying that following the instructions of Guru Maharaj.
Yes, Prabhu, very right answer. Malati Mataji, you have any other point you can
By inquiring about the spiritual knowledge, Prabhu. Whatever he is saying, not blindly listening, but we should inquire and acquire some knowledge through him.
Submissively, we have to inquire by surrendering to the spiritual master, and we have to follow that Raghunath Puri Prabhu rightly said that we have to follow the instructions of spiritual master. Like, if you don't follow, you will fall down. If you follow the instructions of spiritual master, you will be liberated. Very right answer. If anyone wants to add any other point, you can add it, or else we'll go further.
I have a simple question, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu.
Question is that, why should we follow the instructions of the spiritual master?
Very good question, Prabhu. Matajis and Prabhujis, if anyone wants to answer, please try to answer Prabhu question.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Basically, when we are following the instructions of a guru who is representative of God, so directly we please our guru as well as also Krishna. So that's why we need to follow all. If we have to understand blindly, we have to follow the instruction of guru, and also guru comes in the disciplic succession. So I think Prabhuji, that's why the main reason for we should be following guru's instruction, and it also helps us in our purity within stages, because guru is the only person who is going to guide us.
Veeranmal Prabhu also tried to give some answer, Prabhu.
Same thing I want to tell
Prabhu. Sorry, Prabhu.
Same thing already covered by Ravana.
Okay, Prabhu. If any other Matajis or Prabhujis want to add to this question, they can.
So, one of the things is that why we should follow the instructions of the spiritual master. See, we are, because of the material contamination that we are having, we have popped up our ego so much that we are unable to obey the instructions of the Supreme Lord. See, we know that what is right and what is wrong. Okay, and we have disobeyed and we came here. Now, how do I go back again, back to Godhead? By following his instructions. And in that process of following the instructions, the Guru is helping us to follow the instructions of the Supreme Lord. Because we are not able to connect to Krishna directly, or we are not able to hear. So the bridge between the Krishna to follow the instruction is coming via the Guru because of his own mercy. We are taking that. And in this process, what is eventually happening is that we are surrendering. And surrendering is the only way. if you see the final ultimate instruction that Krishna gives in Bhagavad Gita is sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja. But we are not able to surrender. That is our biggest problem. And that surrendering will be able to, we can able to do it because the guru, especially the life guru, when he is there, when he gives you the instructions, he is going to see your psychophysical nature. He will see me, he will be able to understand how I can make him surrender to Krishna. So he will personally intervene, and because of his mercy, you will be able to surrender to Krishna. If not, you are not in a position, understand that you cannot directly surrender to Krishna. No, because it is not, it has to go through a Vaya process only. When you surrender to Krishna, to your guru, then you are able to get the mercy of your guru, and in turn Krishna is happy because you have surrendered to his representative. So that is what we should understand, and that is the, and practically if you say I have surrendered to Krishna, but you are not really practically surrendered to Krishna. But when you practically surrender to your guru, you are really doing it, not just theoretically. So that way, practically, if you wanted to practice surrender, guru is the only way. So that's what we need to understand. And that's the reason why it is very important that you have to follow the instructions of the guru. And in turn, as Raghunath Puri Prabhu rightly mentioned, it purifies us. And purifies what? Our false ego. It will remove that anarthas, ignorance, as Bhaira Prabhu earlier mentioned. So all this will go away, but that process is what we need to take it. And when you do that, you are eventually going to understand that who I am really. And that way you can get purified and you can get the eligibility to go back to God. Thank you, Prabhu. Hare
Krishna. Thank you, Prabhu. I request once again all the devotees, this is a lengthy chapter. I'll take 5 more minutes. Please kindly bear with me. And before proceeding further, Prabhu, Veeramal Prabhu asked the question, but in case of Gajendra, there are no spiritual guru. If anyone wants to answer this, please, you can try. Prabhu is saying that in Gajendra Moksha, Gajendra don't have any guru, but how he surrendered? If anyone wants to answer, Prabhuji's and Mataji's.
Prabhuji, Gajendra was an animal, right? How he can get a guru?
Okay, Prabhu. I'll come back to you a little bit later, Prabhu. Bhaira Prabhu want to answer?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Actually, Gajendra, in the last life, he was King Indradimna. He was a very great devotee of the Lord. So because of that past life, he remembered as you understand Bhagavad Gita, in one life, whatever endeavor we are doing in the spiritual thing, in next life will continue from there. So though he got a animal body, but that bhakti part was there. So he remembered that and he progressed further. For that, not required in guru. Guru is required for whom? Who are totally neophyte. They know nothing about that. They are complete in ignorance. So for them, guru is required. Who are liberated, though they can also try, because already that flame is ignited inside them. So they can, with their little endeavor, they can progress. That is my opinion, Prabhuji.
Yes, thank you, Prabhu.
Just to add to this episode, very nicely, Veeranaman Prabhu has put forward that crocodile is also not an ordinary crocodile. If you want to get connected with Krishna in whatever way, don't assume that they have done something very bad. In the sense, they get moksha. So once the crocodile also was a Gandharva in the previous, that crocodile's name, if I remember probably, it is Aha or some, and they were dancers and they are Gandharvas. We can discuss about that story. And they got a curse by one of the munis, and they have to as a crocodile that has to come. So put together, all this is a leela. And the question was to ask whether this elephant had a guru or not, as Bhaira Prabhu rightly mentioned. So they are getting that purification slowly, and once they get purified, then they will go back to their original abode. So that is what it happens eventually. And the realization is different for different people. The elephant race, the way that she realized or he realized was through that process.
Yeah, yes, Prabhuji, just to add on in one sentence, actually, if we have read this Gajan Moksha, so in this also, initially, he is in elephant form and he's trying to say, he is proving that he is very strong enough and he can win. But finally, at one point of time, then he remembers and he starts praying. So that is, whole aspect that when we have complete submission to the God, like as you explained earlier also, Sarnagati. So Sarnagati is the most important part which is required.
Fantastic. Very nice. That's the crucial, that is the time when the Supreme Lord intervenes, when he surrendered. So that's very important. Thank you, Prabhu. Excellent.
One more example, we find that Bharat Maharaj, when he had taken the body of a deer, that time also he remembered what a past life, what are the mistakes he has done in the path of bhakti, and he rectified those things, and next life he got Jadavarata, and Jadavarata also he self-controlled, how to behave now, how I should not be distracted by the Maya and all. He behaved himself like that. From the outside world, people were thinking he's a Jada, but actually he was progressing in his own spiritual way. So that was an example also we can take.
So this discussion is so energetic. The point what we need to remember is that though you find that these are all animals, these are all this, that, but finally they are spirit souls. As in this module rightly mentioned, Pandita Samadarshinaha. So that means a Pandita, a learned person, will see all these things as equal vision. They don't really consider, this is an elephant. It doesn't have really the qualities of a human being. Yes, it doesn't have, but if you see, they are spirit souls. They have their consciousness at their level only, but still they are spirit souls. If you ask that way, when you see all these 18, 20 devotees who are there, their consciousness, each one consciousness is different. So you cannot really differentiate that way. What we are equally, because the same is that is soul level. And that's what in this module also Bob asks one question. Are each and every soul the same? That's the question that was asked. Do you remember?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yes, Prabhu, same.
So what is the explanation? I did not get it. So please discuss that.
If anyone wants to elaborate it to Prabhu question, they can do it.
Every soul is same in the. We have discussed a long back that I asked that every soul characteristic is same in among all the 84 lakh species. So it is same whether it is in animal form or lower animals or higher or human beings. Even one is in Krishna consciousness or not, the soul character is same. But the consciousness changes when we connect to the God or when we connect to the servants of the God with the touch of that scriptures, our consciousness varies. And also our karmic reactions differ when we come in contact with this material world.
Very good explanation, Mataji. Prabhu, I'd like to add one point here. Actually, in this module, Bhav asked in such a way that all souls are same. Prabhupada said that qualitatively it is same, but they are individual, and compared to Supreme Personal Deity, it's quantitatively different. And Viranmal Prabhu question, Babi Prabhu said very good answer that Gajendra, his family left him behind and he was helpless condition and he surrendered to God. We can consider him as a guru only. He surrendered to Supreme Personal Deity directly. As Arjuna surrendered.
Draupadi Vastrabharanam case is also like that only, no, Prabhuji.
Sorry,
Krishna
Prabhu.
Krishna not helped till she is helping herself.
Yes. Yes, Prabhu. Very
she is helping herself. She is protecting herself. Krishna is not coming to picture.
Yes, Prabhu. Unless you surrender, Krishna will not come.
So Prabhuji, when we wanted to, though we should not compare, but if you wanted to compare and you wanted to see to see what is the difference between somebody at a spiritual consciousness level, how much they have progressed. One way you can dovetail it, or you can really find out what is the yardstick, what is the KPI. Can somebody tell what is the KPI? How do you know that he is elevated? He is really gone to certain stage. Or in the, for that matter, how do we should not compare devotees, but if at all we wanted to compare, how can you really compare? What is the yardstick of his progress spiritually?
Any Prabhuji Mataji?
Prabhuji, I just say, yeah, Hare Krishna Prabhuji, I just say that if we, first process is that we become samdarshi. We start seeing everyone, others, soul in either in tree or animal or anyone, like a pandita, as we have also read it. So we start being samdarshi for everyone.
Yes, Prabhu. Any other Prabhu? Before Puri Hanuman Prabhu try to answer it, I think.
Yeah, Vaniram Mataji is saying something.
Yes, Vaniram Mataji.
Prabhuji, you are asking about the gurus and all, or just as a person you are asking?
My question was in general. If you see yourself, you see some other person, you tend to compare, and if you wanted to compare and see what are some vital KPIs, so that you can find out whether I have elevated myself or have not elevated, not for any other reason, not to envy, but to ask yourself, I have to reach somewhere, what is that you can compare to find out where you are for your betterment only, for your growth only. And if you wanted to see as a reference, what is that? This is not written anywhere, but I'm trying to analyze things.
As now we can say presently, as we see a pure Prabhuji, you are the pure devotees and we are just teaching from you. So I feel that there is a difference in you teaching us. And
you are saying I am a pure devotee. Okay.
Knowledge is personal knowledge will show us the way. So as Guru Prabhuji, you are there to show us the way. So I feel personally in that way, Prabhuji. How much we read, that is different. But knowing from others, that is the more surrendering to God in that way is
I think all of you got the answer. I'll just, because of the time constraint, I will just give my inputs. I might be not correct, but again, I'm giving it for thought for you to think. It is some analysis. It just came out. How do we really compare ourselves and how do we see others when you see where we are, etc.? See, I see that if you see Radhesham Prabhu, if I see some of the Maharajas, like so many Maharajas are there. What is that when I see myself? And when I see others also, how do I really see that is how much they have surrendered to the process that we are having. Guru, Sadhu and Shastra, if you compare that way also, how much they have surrendered, how much faith that they have developed, how much attachment still they have towards the material things. As we wanted to see ourselves, to check where we are, litmus test wise, whether we are progressing or not, you wanted to find out whether I'm progressing or not, I'm doing chanting. So eventually what will happen is that the attachment that you had previously to certain things, which you were not able to leave without them, now you are able to go without them also. So that kind of a detachment is there. So that means the hankering for the material things have reduced, one. Second thing, you are able to surrender to Guru, Sadhu and Shastra. You are able to cultivate that faith. Earlier your faith was little less. Now your faith is increasing. Your surrendering is increasing. Your attachment towards material things are decreasing. At least these three yardsticks, if you find out, you can also self-assess yourself. See, because a lot of times people come and say, I have been in bhakti for 20 years, but still I can't see any change in myself. But where are you practically putting things in practice? What is recommended? If you don't put it, and again, it is not mechanical. You have to really think about this. It is not a mechanical process. I am doing chanting 16 rounds. But my mechanically, if I do, what purification will happen? Okay, so it will give you some benefit, but again, it will not give you the required benefit. So I can keep on going on this, but point is that Govardhan Prabhu.
I get your answer, Prabhuji.
Thank you, Prabhuji, Mataji, Govardhan Prabhu.
Thank you, Prabhuji. For a good, so you have just explained us exactly.
I request all the devotees. I have few more questions to discuss. If you permit me, I'll take up it, or else we'll take it as a homework.
We'll be done for today, Prabhu. It is more than okay. I might have probably not given room for the rest of the things. Please forgive me for that.
No, Prabhu. Nothing like this. Bottom of my mind, I appreciate each and every devotee for. Patience hearing till the end, and before ending, I just want to show the questions which I've prepared it, and you can take it as a homework. Questions which we have left for today's Guru should be accepted as a representative God. Why? And who is Guru, and what are the symptoms of Guru? These are the questions left to you. And from this module, we learn that Krishna says, just surrender to me, he will take care of everything. We need to surrender it. And Krishna is the first spiritual and first spiritual master, and is the original guru also for us. And I prepared a few more questions. Which knowledge to be taken, like direct Bhagavad Gita knowledge with our own reading, or disciplic succession knowledge? We have to hear from Bhagavad Gita knowledge. Please take it as homework. And another question is, if I pray reverently, faithfully, does Krishna hears me? This is a question I prepared. And what is the business of Krishna? These are the questions I have prepared it. Within 1 minute, I'll try to summarize this entire chapter. The purpose of the real goal of life is to reach Goloka Vrindavan. I'll give you with an example. For example, wherever you travel all over the world, your main aim is I have to reach home. In the similar way, if you take clouds, water also, which has come from the sea, again, at the end, it will reach to the sea. Our, as a spiritual soul, a part and parcel of Supreme Personality of Godhead, from spiritual world, our real goal is to go back to God, spiritual world. With these words, I thank one and all. Really, we extended more time because of your questions, and very important questions which you have raised it. For that time, we taken a little bit more time, and take these questions as homework. And I thank Swati Mataji for so nicely leading us in book reading, and thank all the participants who has made such a nice discussions today. Please excuse me for any mistakes I have done during this session.
Prabhuji, I really personally wanted to thank Govardhan Prabhu, not only for this session, but without him, this Gita Subodhani is whatever we are doing is impossible. And he's been one of the two hands for us, and he has always been rendering this service in the background. I am the person who is coming in the front most of the time, but he is the person who is doing a lot of work in the background. So I, with wholeheartedness and with so much gratitude, I wanted to thank him and giving us the opportunity of his association. Thank you very much, Prabhu.
No, Prabhu, I should thank you, Prabhu, for giving me opportunity. Praising much, Prabhu. I am not deserve, I think.
No, Prabhu. So that's your humble attitude. But again, thank you all for patiently being here. One last input, one of the things I wanted to say is that I will be going out of station from this Saturday. But again, I will definitely try to join in the evening. And also Saturday, Sunday, I will be able to take. But this Saturday, I will be traveling, so I cannot take. The Gita Subodhani is preponed to take on Friday. And the timing will not be the same. It will be from 8:15 because I have a leaders, ISKCON leaders meetings in the sense that Radhesham Prabhu conducts some classes, and I have to attend that. It is still 8:15. So it is 2.5 hours session. So 8:15 to 9:15, please do join on Friday. Those who will not be able to, the recording will be there. But still, I would personally request you to be available on Friday, because Saturday we will not have the classes. We'll have the classes, but it will be the same discussion, perfect question, perfect answers. And I've already, Sandhya Devi has already posted the schedule. Please go through it and please do participate. And then one last input I have is that whenever we are preparing questions, I would request you to prepare 3 to 4, 5, maximum 5 questions. And these questions discuss thoroughly. Don't go in a rush to have so many questions and address all the questions. One question, address it thoroughly, analyze it properly. That is where you can really get into this Krishna consciousness, and you will get confidence on what is Krishna consciousness, what is Bhagavad Gita. Try to relate from so many angles, and that's how we analyze things. And so once again, do the discussion. It should not be question and answers. Question and answer. It's not right or wrong is not the point. The point is that did I participate? Each one of you participate. Preferably those who have not been able to speak, please speak. Because unless and until you speak, nothing will go inside. And you will not be able to appreciate Bhagavad Gita unless and until you start getting involved. And that involvement is through this discussion. Please do that. And you have been doing wonderfully, most of you. Yes, but those who are not been able to, don't have any apprehension. What other person will think, whether it's correct or not, doesn't matter. Just participate. So that's the service again. Please understand that. Participation is also a service. Because you are doing it not with for your self-glorification or anything. It is just to understand Krishna. You are connecting to Krishna. That's all what you wanted. And I am sure one day you will be able to speak. You will be able to understand the philosophy of Krishna consciousness much more than the person who has been reading Bhagavad Gita on his own. Than going into this way of learning, which is through discussion, through devotee association. Again, I forgive for the time that I have taken in this particular module and also today. So see you all tomorrow in the group chanting session. Please do attend. And once again, thank you Govardhan Prabhu and Swati Mataji. Tomorrow it is, tomorrow is the...
Friday.
Tomorrow is what Bhagavad Gita I'm going to take. Please come at 8:15. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Govardhan Prabhu, Hare Krishna. Thank you.
Hare Krishna Prabhu, dhanyavad pranam.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. Hare Krishna Prabhu.